Our next guest pushing back on the notion that all young black Americans are progressive. Featured in a New York Post op-ed, they say now is the time for Republicans and black Americans to unite over conservative values. Political commentator and YouTuber Charrise Lane and CEO of the Conscious Conservative Movement, Felecia Killings, they both join us now. Good morning.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
Thank you for coming on with us. So Charrise, tell us why are you conservative?
Well, first of all, I would say that I was raised in a Christian home. My grandparents are pastors, and they raised my mother to be Christian and conservative, which in turn had her raise me to be Christian and conservative. But it wasn't until I was in middle school that I realized I was conservative. I attended a school called Victory Christian Academy in Orlando, Florida, a predominantly black and Christian school. And it wasn't until about the seventh grade that my teacher, Ms. Randolph, she advised us to research both sides of political parties and also to look at what a conservative is and what a liberal is. And after I did that, that's when I came to the realization that I was conservative. But I was raised Christian and I was raised conservative, so it came natural to me with that realization.
Mm-hmm. How about you, Felecia?
My father raised me to be conservative. This is just all I know. Big shout out to Dad right now, who's watching. And this is pretty much the experience for a lot of black Americans. We are conservative in our values. However, there has been a significant gap between the Republican Party and black voters. And right now, what we're trying to do with the Conscious Conservative Movement is to bridge that gap via education and training, just talking to black voters as well as to white conservatives so that we understand that there are commonalities. And if we show up, I'm telling you that it's going to be a powerful experience, even in the political spectrum.
Mm-hmm. Charrise, according to Pew Research, 4 in 10 black Democratic voters call themselves moderate, but the Democratic Party doesn't seem to be moderate anymore. It's so progressive.
Right. I definitely agree. And I would say that historically, black Americans, we are conservative. When it comes to conservatism, I believe that that does not align. It doesn't have to do anything with political parties. Mm-hmm. When you are conservative, it has to do with values. And that's what I tell everyone. You can be conservative and not be a Republican. You can be conservative and be a Democrat. You can be conservative and be independent. The point is, black Americans are historically conservative. And just because, you know, they are black doesn't mean they have to be liberal or they have to be Democrat. They are historically conservative.
Felecia, you say black Americans are looking for a political home. What do you think will happen next year with the midterms and then when we choose another president down the road?
I think right now conservatives and Republicans have an opportunity to bridge this gap, to make these alliances. This is something that I share with beloved conservatives almost daily on Twitter class. It's about understanding black history. It's about understanding that black history is on the side of conservatism. And if we can espouse these messages in a more empowering way, as opposed to a degrading, dehumanizing manner, we're going to see more black Americans, especially black millennials, especially among black male voters. We'll start to see more of them aligning themselves with conservative politics because conservatism has promised to protect our growing black wealth, which we are eagerly building day in and day out.
All right. Well, you made your dad proud, Felecia. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And Charrise, thank you. God bless you.
I'm Steve Ducey.
I'm Brian Kilmeade.
And I'm Ainsley Earhart. And click here to subscribe to the Fox News YouTube page to catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis.